All right, Brad, wanted to give you a walkthrough of the radio, kind of verbally explain what does what to some degree here. I'm sure I'll miss a couple things, so I'll be on the phone with you, of course, as things progress. But okay, so we're set on your next level 500 right now. I guess I can start there. When you have your radio off to go into which model you want to be on, I'm sure you already know this. Looks like you've set up a couple channels. You hold the enter button and turn it on the radio. You can go to your model select at that point. And it looks like you got three guys here, your Gowie, Fun Cub, and Next Level. So we want your Next Level. Your wing type isn't really something that you're going to mess with until you're actually flying airplanes. It allows you to mix a few things and you know, like your aileron and your elevator. Few things like that that some people want to set up a little differently. A wing, for instance, has two ailerons, or they call them elevons because it's elevator and aileron control on two control surfaces instead of spread out between a wing set that has ailerons and then a tail that has an elevator. So that's what that's for. You're not really going to need that or use that. So go out to your main screen here. And let's go into your list options here. We've got a whole bunch of different menus and list. The first one's DNR and Expo. So what you're doing here effectively is aileron, elevator, and rudder are all configurable to a two-way switch, and there's a separate switch for each one. Elevator, elevator's over here. This is your DNR for elevator, dual rates. Your aileron, dual rates, and your rudder, dual rates. So you can have, and they're two-way switches, the forwardmost position is zero, and you pull that to you, and that's position one. So zero and one, zero and one, zero and one. Elevator, aileron, rudder. Let's go back down here, show you what you're doing. Okay, so right now, set up at 80. I'm going to take it back to 100. This is default. And what you're doing here is you're telling it at position zero, you want your throws to be 100%. Now, if this was a servo, which it's not, it's a flight control board, what you're doing is you're telling it to use 100% of its capability of throw. If you take this guy down to 80%, you're taking the end points down to 80% of what they normally would be at 100. And you're still at 100 here on position 1. So right now, if you left it this way, your aileron channel, position 0 and 1, 80 and 100. So aileron channel, position 0 right now, would be 80% of your throw, which would effectively wouldn't give you as much ability to aileron right or left. So you flip it to 1, and now that gives you 100% of capability of what it's going to allow you to throw aileron. That same goes with rudder and elevator. So basically it's just an assignable switch, and you can make it more, you know, you could have two different modes where you fly, you know, position 0 all the way around is going to be nice and smooth, and then when you want to go nuts, you got it set up for crazy dual rates or something. You know, you can flip those all forward to position 1, and she'll go crazy for you. So, okay, you also have Expo in this screen. Expo right now I have set up to 30 and 50. And all that really does is it deadens the sensitivity of your cyclic stick. This is the cyclic stick. This is your rudder, left and right, and throttle. But when I say cyclic stick, this is the stick I'm referring to. Right now, position 0 is at 30%. So position 0, and this is also going to change your dual rates. You know, you can change these switches. It'll also change whatever you have set up here for Expo. So if you have 30% Expo and 80% throws DNR on your aileron channel, that's going to translate to this switch, and this will control both of those. So we got 30% Expo on your, and this is kind of cool too. The 9303 does this. You can actually manually push the switch right or left. My thumb's doing this. If you watch the screen there, it's actually showing you which side So you could actually set up to have more 40% at left or 46% expo on the left stick and 30% on right. So it's really super configurable, but really all you want to do is you just want to set them to the same, and you can control how sensitive your stick is around center. So the more expo you add in, the less sensitive it will be around center. So that's dual rates and expo for you. Reverse switches are, they're what they are. If you have your elevator, you're pulling up and the nose is pushing down, then it's reversed. You got to reverse it on here, and that fixes that. Your sub trims, you're not really going to mess with. They're basically just another point of adjustment for, a face trim. I believe, if I'm right, on a servo, it actually centers. It shows the servo that whatever position you put in here is actually its center. And then the difference between that and the face trim is that you're just giving it an input like you would with the stick, except for it's doing it for you here on a clicker instead of you having to feed it an input. Your travel adjust. These guys, you're always, when you set up your NASA, it just wants everything linear, so 100 and 100. You leave those where they are. Basically, what travel adjust does, let's go back to servos again. If you have a servo, 100 and 100, you can, it's the same thing as dual rates, DNR. Dual rates means that you have a dual, position switch that you can adjust the rates. The rates it's calling, or what it's referring to when they say rates, dual rates, is how much you have your throw set at, how high you have it or how low you have it set at. So your throttle position switch here, we could take your high, see L and H, so it's low and high. We could go to high stick and we could bring your throttle position down so that you're only getting 80% of your available throttle. So we're gonna take that back up to 100. The NASA wants to see linear all the way around here. So I guess what I'm saying here is your aileron. Let's take that and go. We could take your aileron and go to 80% right and left. And what you'd be doing is you actually feed it the input here to change. You can see how that works. I'm actually showing it which end to look at. So what I just did here is instead of doing it on dual rates, I just did where you're at 80% at zero stick on your dual rates menu. Well, what I did here is I actually just manually made it set for your whole aileron channel is set at 80%. So basically I did the same thing here. It's just another point of travel adjustment. So once again, bring those back up to 100. And just so you know, this radio here, the default settings, which these are 100, if you want to put them back at 100, you can highlight whatever you're working on and hit clear, and it'll do it for you because it knows that it's supposed to be at 100. So basically, you have the ability to adjust the endpoints of each channel here. So we're not going to mess with that. Go back here to main menu. Elevator flap mix is an airplane thing. You're not going to mess with this guy. You're not going to mess with aileron rudder mix. You're not going to mess with your throttle curve, flap system, snap roll, servo speed. None of the mixes you're going to use for multi-rotors. Trainer, I believe that just, let's see. Yeah, that's where you would set up a buddy box, but I don't believe you're going to be messing around with that, so I'm not going to go through that. Your timer, we do have set right now downtime of 7 minutes. So you can actually inhibit this downtime or stop W. I'm not even sure what stop W is. I use downtime. And what that allows you to do here is choose what you want to, how long you want to fly. So let's start you off at 6 minutes here. And when you hit, I'll take you back out to the main screen and show you. So when you hit your bottom button here on the left hand side of the LCD display, that's going to start timing, it's going to start going down. There she goes. So now it's counting down. I think it at the last couple minutes gives you a one beep, I believe, warning for each minute you're coming down on. And then once you get down to the last 10 seconds, it'll start a sequence of beeping that, you know, you'll definitely know what I'm talking about when it happens. So it lets you know when you're done, when your time's over and you're done flying. So you can adjust that. I would say, like we talked on the phone, you can adjust that. You're at 6 minutes right now. If you want to, if you're putting back like, if you're only putting back just a little bit into your battery and you have way more battery you can use and still be under 80% of the capacity, you can step that up another minute, you know, so take it up to 7, and 8 even. I believe you're going to be getting pretty good flight times with your bird, so we're going to start at 6 minutes for you, and as soon as you arm the machine, reach down here and click, you know, your downtime, and your time will start there, and it's still going. If you hit clear, that's going to reset your time back to 6, so don't hit that button. To initialize, to arm your next level NASA, your I guess it isn't a next level product, but the NASA on your next level, you're going to go diagonally inward and downward on your two sticks here, and that's what arms your NASA. So when you do that, your props will start to spin in an idle position. It's not going to try to take off on you, but they will start to spin, and you can let it go back out to center, and if you don't touch anything in a couple seconds, it'll disarm again. So when you do this, the props will turn on and start to spin, and then you want to feed it a little bit of, you know, you don't have to punch it or anything, but you can feed it a little bit of throttle, and then it will stay running at least in an idle position, and it won't shut off back off on you again. So I think I've covered just about everything on there. Right now we got, this is your aux 1 and aux 2 switches. They're three-way position switches, but you do have to go to the extreme one way or the other to have your Pico switches actually switch so that they see the two endpoints. If you go from here to here, nothing will happen. If you go to from here all the way, that'll switch it. So right now we got your video set here on and off, and your LEDs here set on and off. And I'm not sure which one is on, which one's off. I'd have to hook up your bird and look. But I believe this one on is here, and off is here, and same here, I think. So that's your radio, man. All right, Brad. So thought I'd run to the park real quick and give you like a little quick verbal walkthrough of some of the things that I'm going to do in flight that you'll be able to see. You know, as I'm talking, you'll be able to see how it reacts to manual mode and attitude mode. I'll show you what altitude hold does, and just kind of verbally walk you through a flight. So anyway, got your lights hooked up to your aux 1 switch, and later on I'll show you a view of the radio so you can see as well what I'm talking about. But so there's your lights on your Pico switch. And to arm the NASA, you hold both sticks diagonally down, inward and down, and that will arm your quad, and it'll start to spin the props. And from there, you can, here I'll arm it and show you. You can let it sit, and it'll end up dying and turning back off, and now it's not armed anymore. Or you arm and give it some throttle, and she's ready to go. So right now we're in attitude mode. She is stable, holding altitude. Bump it up a little bit. So at mid-stick or above, once you get it to a hover position and it's holding altitude, it'll go into altitude hold. And it's extremely accurate within 10 centimeters until your battery starts to wear down. then you can kind of start seeing it getting inaccurate. So right now, not given any throttle input whatsoever. This is all the right stick. See that correct itself right there. Pretty crazy. All right, now manual mode, I'm gonna go ahead and set up your radio so that you don't really have the option of going into manual mode, but I'd like to show you what it'll do so that it, you know, when you get comfortable flying this machine, you'll be able to give me a ring and we'll program your radio again for doing manual mode. This gives you a lot more response all the way around. There's no stabilization. Doing just exactly what you tell it to do. And as you can see, she's fast. So your indicator light on the NASA will slow blink yellow when you're first into your pack. You got a nice full charge. And basically your flashing in between will get more rapid as the battery goes down. And it'll start to change from yellow to red. So once we got a red flashing rapid light, you're gonna get ready for auto land. Go ahead and kill the battery a bit and now from here to the end of the flight, I'm not going to touch the throttle unless I need to. Just to show you how long you can go. Ah, there's our first red flashing. So pretty quick here. Ah, there's red flashing. All right, she's going to go into auto land here any second. I haven't touched the throttle and I'm not going to until she hits the ground. I'll show you what she does. Ah, there she goes. She's all by itself. So the motors are staying on because I'm still at a throttle position, so I'll take them down and they'll disarm. So there you go, man. All right, dude, here is your next level. She's all done, prettied up. Got nice wire covering all over everything for the most part. Tried to hide the wires as much as possible. This is your FPV gear power. So you're actually powering your FPV gear separately with a little guy, little 850 milliamp 3S pack. So make sure to remember to recharge that guy every four flights or so. But it should last you, you know, four or five flights, but, just don't forget, go up there, get out of view and then lose your video. You'll be hosed. So anyway, got your top plate on here, kind of protecting your flight board in there. All your ESCs are tucked up into the sides here as much as possible. There's not a lot of real estate on the next level for, mounting components. So it's kind of a mess, but, that's kind of how it goes. That's about as clean as they get for the next level. And your radio transmitter, it's right here. I got her strapped in. Because it's directly under the prop, I'm not worried about there not being enough airflow to it. But normally these get nice and hot while they're being used. So we just got your little omnidirectional guy on here. And so far, I can, you know, from what I've tested here, it's working pretty well. I don't know that you'll need anything more than this until you're starting to go around big obstacles and, you know, maybe flying from one side of the house to the other and you're no longer in line of sight. This might not do the job at that point, but we can talk about getting you into circular polarized antennas at that point. Here's your LED strips, go around the arms. We got red tail lights and blue headlights. And what else? You got your main payload mount under here. Basically, you know, super extended, nice long mount here on both sides so that you can get your CG, your center of gravity, close to center. You know, this is where you want your center. Both axes should be center of the quad, but that's not always the perfect you know, a lot of times you don't quite get that. But wanted to put this guy in here so you can put your battery slid backwards a ways. I'm going to grab another strap for you so you can strap that guy nice tight here. I didn't do Velcro. I did actually, a buddy of mine, he put a next level together, and he put some of this stuff on his bird. Seems to work really nice. It just keeps it from, you don't have to yank your battery off of there every time you're doing it. You just unstrap it and slide it out. And once it's strapped in there, man, it is nice and tight. It ain't going nowhere. It's that anti-slip shelf stuff. So when you get your GoPro in here, you know, that'll put about 7 ounces up here. And then you can slide your battery back a little ways until it feels about right for CG. And she should fly really nice for you. So that's your next level, man. All pretty.